And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Blind. I'm the RPG chick. I believe we're headed now to... Unless we get interrupted by something. Or distracted by something. We're going to, go check up on Liara. See what she's doing with the Shadow Broker. Shadow Broker DLC type stuff. The mass relay is over here. So let's fuel up and stuff. And then use it. So we're actually done with this cluster. The Hourglass Nebula. Finally! Because we were in the middle of exploring... We explored this one, Osen. Actually used a tiny bit of fuel. And then we got interrupted and sent to Horizon, way off somewhere. Fuel, probes, mass relay, and help Liara, give Liara intel, which is at the Crescent Nebula system. Have I even been there before? I'm just checking, because I know sometimes they add stuff. We've been to Omega Cluster, Serpent Nebula, Eagle Nebula, Ismar Frontier, Hourglass Nebula, and the Shadow Sea. So, we have not been there. So, now we are there. Ilium. Why does that sound familiar? Let's just explore the other systems. We have all this stuff to do on this one planet. Holy crap. We're gonna be busy. Let's check out all the other planets, though, and be thorough and all that stuff. Where's the outermost planet? Must be hanging out by itself somewhere down here. Oh no, that's the mass relay. Never mind. Oh, I stopped moving. So it should still be at full fuel, yeah. Okay, so that last orbit is the mass relay. This planet is called Naxel. I used to buy cassette tapes, blank cassette tapes, by a company named Maxel. Here we got Naxel. It's an ammonia-methane ice giant. Several smaller energy corporations shut out of the big market in the Feia Gateway system are attempting to develop a local helium-3 fuel mining infrastructure to service Ilium. The leading investor is the human corporation Eltfel Ashland Energy. Their efforts have been hampered by the extra-legal pressure the H3 cartels in Feia system can bring to bear, from simple price undercuts to bureaucratic obstructions, denied permits, and constant health and safety inspections. Well, that sounds annoying. Population 6,700. The capital is EAE Krafka. Stands for Electronic Arts Evil. Day. An entire day is only 10 hours. Hmm. And it's interesting how we don't have other information on this system. Like the gravity and the atmospheric pressure. Well, let's scan the thing. Moderate. I might not get anything here, actually. I don't want to launch a probe. I do not need this stuff. That's not a lot of platinum. Well, this is better.
Away.
We went automatically from moderate to poor just with that. Alright, we're done. There's a population here, but we can't land here. or we won't land here, whichever. Alright, so what's this other one here? Oh, cool. I love the rings like that. Thale. Thale is a typical hydrogen helium gas giant. Its complex system of rings is unstable. Dating back only a few million years, they are thought to be the shattered remains of a comet. Cool. Shattered comet. Music changes sometimes. I thought it held some significance for some reason. Even though I've heard it do so before. I think it's just started the loop. Loop over. Don't need iridium or palladium, really. Hold on a second. Huh. I don't know, it seemed different to me. Something about that. I'm losing my mind! Ilium is here. Alright. Alright, this one. Ponilus. A fairly typical Venusian hothouse, Ponilus seems almost tame compared to the violent volcanic outbursts of the inner world Barrigale. In contrast, Ponilus is nearly inert with no active volcanoes or plate tectonics. The most dramatic event in the last million years was the foundering of the Asari Aerostat Research Platform Alveusic in 2092, which fell after being holed by an improbably unlucky meteor. Well, the meteor was lucky, they were unlucky. Most of the crew successfully reached escape capsules, but six were lost. The crushed wreck of the platform now lies on the Creosite Plain in the southern hemisphere. So its year is three times that of Earth, or 3 years to one. Gravity is mostly the same. See, this is the stuff that was missing off the other planet. How odd. Oh my god, the atmospheric pressure is insane. Alright, let's scan. Well, that's certainly a lot of platinum. I can't resist that, can I? Right here.
Probe away.
How many probes have I launched and the game's still, like, telling me how to do it? Can't you store that data and decide that I know how to do it? Platinum.
Probe away.
I might just start getting some iridium now and then, just to round everything up to 100. 100 thou. Why not?
Probe launched.
I'll get there pretty quickly. Iridium's pretty common. Let's get both.
Probe away.
Okay, so we're officially there with palladium. We're over 100,000. Just over. So I will now get some iridium just until we get to 1,000. I mean, 100,000. 100k. Alright, done. I doubt if we'll ever need that much, but you never know. Okay, ilium, we're gonna go here first and look at this one. Barrigale. While not a classical hothouse world like Venus, Barrigale or Barrigale? Oh, they got a typo here because they spelled it different here as well. It's scarcely more hospitable. In addition to being closest to the star T'Sail, its core contains many radioactives and other heavy elements. These increase the heat of the planets and drive volcanism. Baragel's crust is too frigid for plate tectonics to function, and the planet will go through cycles in which the pressure builds to a massive supervolcanic eruption. These spew ejecta over thousands of kilometers, leave caldera 100 kilometers across, and spew enough molten material to repave entire continents. That's a lot. Last such event was 812,000 years ago. That was yesterday. The current rate of outgassing from volcanic hotspots suggests another will occur within the next 10 millennia. I can't wait. Surface gravity about twice that of Earth. A day is almost twice as long. And other stuff. Let's scan. It's rich in volcanic crap. These volcanoes, man. They got some nerve, don't they?
Probe away.
Oh, what did we get? Palladium? I wasn't gonna get any more of that. Damn it. Don't need palladium. Got so much. Save my money for other things. I got some... yeah. Here, I'll get some iridium here.
Probe launched.
We'll get to that 100,000 pretty quickly for iridium. Hey, hey.
Probe launched.
And if I ever need more, I can just go to more planets. Maybe off-screen and get more. Alright, we're done. Let's check out this Ilium. Sounds so familiar, I guess because I've heard about it in the game. Mm-hmm. So the Justicar is here, the Assassin's here, two new crew members. Miranda needs help here. And Liara. Later for Miranda. Go for Liara. Ilium is a classic garden world developed to serve as an entrepot? I'm not sure what that word is. Oh, look at that, how it's all glistening and stuff. That's freaking awesome. I like that. We can't probe this planet, or scan this planet, rather. Both. So it's an entrepot between the Terminus systems and the Asari Republics. To abet this trade, the normally stringent customs laws of Council Space on product safety, prescribed materials, and sapient trafficking are relaxed. Officially, Ilium is not an Asari world. It is colonized and operated by Asari corporate interests. This gives it the same legal latitude enjoyed by the human corporate research enclaves of Novaria. Ilium is one of the youngest Asari colonies settled during the 7th expansion wave. The first child born on the world is only now reaching her middle age. The world, which could be hundreds of years though, right? The world is hot and massive. A ground settlement is only possible at the higher polar latitudes. In more equatorial locations, the population is housed in arcology skyscrapers to escape the heat of the surface. Ah, so it's freaking hot there. Colony founded in 1617. Earth years, right? Wow. And it's what? 23-something? 24-something now? Okay. I guess it's like 800 years, 700-800 years. Hmm. Still, to think this place, an Asari is middle age at this point, who was born around the year 1617 or slightly after. I mean, what, we hadn't even had the American Revolution yet. Population on the surface is 84,900,000. Population at the L4 and L5 stations is 80,300. Capital is Nos Astra. Orbital period is 1.5 Earth years. Day length is 25 Earth hours, very similar. We might not even notice the difference if you move there, as far as that. Atmospheric pressure is slightly above that of Earth. Surface temperature is a very warm 63 Celsius. Surface gravity is almost identical at 1.2 G. Let's land. Interested to see this place, maybe walking around in another station or city or something like that. Who would I bring this time? Let's bring Garrus. Wait, I got info. Add. Bringing Garrus. Wow, he's the only original crew member. Because I'm sure he'd love to see Liara again. And, I mean, really, in my playthrough, they only had a few, like, conversations in the turbo lift or elevators or whatever they're calling them. I'm definitely not interested in Miranda helping at this point. Leaning towards Morden. Yeah, let's bring Morden and Garrus. Kind of thinking of Liara with my selections here. I'm so thoughtful, aren't I? Okay, I think we're a little bit higher in Paragon than we were. Or are we not? I don't even know. Okay, so I have two. I'm holding out. He has overload. I've learned a lot about this game since I've been playing, guys, so... Concussive shot or overload? Let's take concussive shot. And Mr. Morden. I'm gonna save his points. This looks neat, Neural Shock. So, whenever I make him loyal, I'll probably use my points here. Cryoblasto. Snap freezing impact to targets. Eh. It's a lot like the cryo ammo, isn't it? Seems like. Okay, let's check out what Garrus is using. Do we like the collector assault rifle? Let's use the Vindicator, at least for now. Yeah. And I only have one sniper rifle, so... Morden using Locust and Carnifex hand cannon. Yeah. Here we come, Ilium. Awesome. Cool, those magnetic arm things. Yet we didn't see it attach itself. Greetings! Are these people, right? Why do they look like androids?
Welcome to Nos Astra, Commander Shepard.
Here are
We've
androids.
Been instructed to waive all docking and administration fees for your visit. My name is Karina. If you need information about the area, it would be my pleasure to assist you.
Why do I get the free pass?
Who instructed you to waive the fees?
The order came from Liara T'Soni, who paid
Aww.
All fees on your behalf.
What a sweetie.
She also asked that I direct you to speak with her at your convenience. She's near the trading floor.
Okay, sounds good. I do have a few questions, though. How is Liara?
You said Liara was here? What is she doing?
Liara is one of Nos Astra's most respected information brokers.
Oh?
Nos Astra is based upon trade. Information is valuable currency, and Liara has done quite well. As I said, you'll find her near the trading floor. She was looking forward to seeing you.
As am I. Trading floor?
You mentioned trading. What gets traded on Ilium?
Anything you can imagine, Commander. Ilium is a wonderful world for those who can afford it. In order to remain competitive as a Terminus systems port, we've relaxed many of the standards you'd find on other Asari worlds.
Yeah.
Most drugs are legal, provided they are labeled properly. You can buy almost any weapon or technology. You can even buy indentured servants.
Slavery? That's disgusting.
I can't believe an Asari world would allow slavery.
We try to avoid calling it slavery.
Yeah, I'm sure you do.
All indentured servants on Ilium have voluntarily agreed to a term of service. Most choose indentured service as a means to pay off debt or avoid imprisonment.
Some choice.
A contract holder is responsible for the well-being of her servants, and a servant's duties are agreed upon before the contract is signed.
It's still slavery. If that's their choice between prison or what else did she say? That's not much of a choice. They should be paid. Well-being contract. I don't see that they're actually paid money. They're mostly given an offer they can't refuse, right? Tell me about Nos Astra.
What can you tell me about Nos Astra?
It's an exciting city. We see a lot of new cultures and goods because of our proximity to the Terminus systems. At the same time, Ilium is still an Asari world. You should be as safe here as you would be on the Citadel. For your own safety, however, I recommend against signing anything.
Huh? I can't sign anything?
What's so dangerous about signing something?
Ilium is a free trade world, Commander. Contract term requirements are more relaxed here than on other planets. It's a small price to pay for keeping our competitive edge in goods from the Terminus systems.
So I might inadvertently sign my life away and become an indentured servant? What kind of attractions are there here?
Do you have any recommendations about what to do on Nos Astra?
Our trading center is directly ahead. You'll find restaurants and shops nearby as well. I suggest you browse our shopping kiosks. You can find things on Nos Astra that you can't find anywhere else in the galaxy.
Sounds intriguing. Oh, by the way, I'm looking for someone. I guess besides Liara.
I'm on a mission. Can you help me find someone?
Miranda's
sister?
I can
help you find major entertainment centers or stores, but I'm afraid I can't point you to individual people.
Well, damn it.
Liara is excellent at that type of work, however. I imagine she can help you.
What good are you, then? Goodbye.
Thank you.
Again, welcome to our city, Commander. Please enjoy your stay.
Customs records indicated just a car named Samara is visiting this port, Shepard. Your former teammate, Liara T'Soni, may have more information. Her office overlooks the trading floor. You may wish to speak with her regarding the whereabouts of Thane Krios, the assassin on your dossier, as well.
Thank you, Edie. Check our journal. Still have to get caught up on Codex. Talk to Liara. Overlooking trading floor, Morden. Oh, really? Morden has a personal matter he wishes to discuss? In his lab. Well, he's here with me. Jack has a personal matter she wishes to discuss. Talk to Jack. Okay. I guess once we arrive here, all this stuff unlocks. Maybe this is what you guys were talking about. Dossier, the assassin, Thane Krios. Alright, so when we return, you know, I'm definitely going to talk to everybody. Some people have stuff they want to talk about, and others might just have, a few things to say. Thane Krios is a Drell. What the hell is a Drell? Trained from childhood as an elite assassin, proficient in both long-range sniping kills and close infiltration. He has slowed his activities in recent years, but is rumored to have a target on Ilium. Quick kill biotic specialist and an expert sniper. And the Justicar Samara? Can't help but think of the girl from the ring. Her name is Samara. 7 days. Biotic strength near that of an Asari matriarch. Wow. And extensive weapons training. She's a Justicar, a rare member of an Asari monastic group trained in enhanced combat biotics alongside standard weapons. Samara was recently sighted on Ilium outside normal Asari space. She never sleeps. Yeah. Okay. Done with stuff. So all this stuff was just added. You guys saw this. So maybe this is what you meant to talk about, Talk to Morden, someone specifically said. And we want to talk to somebody else as well, Jack. So, apparently it gets unlocked as soon as we arrive here. Anything else to say?
Commander, a pleasure to see you again. Can I help you with something?
Nope.
Thank you.
Have a pleasant visit to Nos Astra, Commander.
You can help me by allowing me to say thank you to you. Okay, airlock. We don't need to go in there. Readouts of stuff. Let's save. Actually, here. Let's do quick save. For some reason I forgot about quick save for a few videos. Just in case we get stuck on something. That's great.
That slavery is an inextricable part of their caste system.
Oh, brother.
And that by limiting the slave trade, the council is violating their cultural rights. The indentured servitude market closed down 3 points, with representatives decrying the unwanted controversy.
Cry me a river. Gara switched to see the sights with us. Wow. I love this. This game is freaking awesome. Looks like dome. Like dome habitats or something over there. Look at all that traffic. Wow. Well, I could stand here forever. Garrus?
We were always told that Ilium is one of the safest places in the galaxy, until you fell off the grid. Sign the wrong contract, join up with the wrong company, or walk down the wrong alley, and it's as dangerous as anywhere else. Don't let this place fool you. It's no safer here than Omega.
I believe that. I believe it. It's just a little more deceptive than Omega. Omega, you can tell, is full of, criminal scum a couple minutes after you walk on there. Here's a little more hidden. Galactic news.
The prison ship Purgatory has been destroyed following an apparent riot. Security ships are en route to the area to retrieve prisoners and guards from life pods.
Oh. Yeah. I mean, they were just doing a job. Anything else?
Certa Foundation is likely to close by the end of this fiscal year. The Foundation never recovered from a deadly attack by biotic extremists on one of its medical centers 2 years ago.
Oh yeah. One of our missions in the first Mass Effect.
A quiet candlelight vigil is planned for hostages who died during the Batarian attack on Terra Nova. Reverend Michael Bowman, whose daughter Kate died in the fighting, is holding a non-denominational prayer service on the anniversary of the attack.
Kate Bowman. That's another name that sounds familiar.
Shepherd Memorial Plaza on Elysium was voted this year's hottest wedding location. Under Admiral Hackett's orders, money raised from wedding fees goes to funds for Alliance veterans.
We've heard that one. Let's listen to one more just in case.
25. Sell at 25.
No, no, no. You're not hearing me. I want to buy it up. Buy it all up.
Yeah.
Come on.
All of it?
Give me something.
Explorer ships have reported seeing vessels of an unknown make, but whose silhouette strongly resembles ancient Rachni ship profiles. The few ships sighted have been small scouting vessels that rapidly retreated. The Council has pledged a full investigation.
I wonder how Rachni make ships.
Sources say that the Asari Shaira, more commonly known as the Consort, may be leaving the Citadel after years of bad press and rumors of intelligence.
Are you shorting prefabs?
Why not? I did it after Eden Prime. Paid for new exosuits for my kids.
You're insane.
Oh, we could talk to Morden about this vista?
Asari building structure resembles Hive. Tall buildings filled with drones. Curious social dynamic. Many queens competing for Hive leadership. Odd feelings around Asari. Unfamiliar. Reminders of old fertility contract negotiations.
You mean you're getting horny or something?
Short sell on prefabs after these human colony attacks. They're going to see a ton of business.
A ton of immediate charity business. followed by a freeze as new colony plans dry up. Just watch. Sell!
Nah.
Excuse me, are you Commander Shepard?
Excuse me, yes, I'm Commander Shepard.
You're Commander Shepard? I saw your... I guess you would say your aura.
My aura?
I'd recognize you anywhere. I was asked to give you a message if I saw you. It's from a friend you made on Novaria.
I'm listening.
What message were you asked to give?
Shepard, we hide.
Oh.
We borrow.
Oh my.
We build. But we know that you seek those who soured the songs of our mothers.
Arachnai.
When the time comes,
ooh,
our voice will join with yours.
Oh, that's freaky.
And our crescendo will burn the darkness clean. Thank you, Shepard. The Arachnai will sing again. Because of you.
Now that's freaky the way her mouth is moving. I'm gonna have nightmares later, I feel like. Sheesh. Well, I want to ask them. I want to do this, but I want to also find out, are you on Ilium?
I'm glad to hear that you're rebuilding. Are you somewhere close by?
The Arachnai Queen is not here. That message is one of many memories I carry from her.
Oh.
I encountered her on an uncharted world. She saved my life.
She did.
More than that, she gave me a purpose. They are an amazing people, Shepard. The galaxy owes you a great debt for giving them a second chance.
Hmm. So at least some payoff of me saving the Queen back in the Mass Effect, the first game. Tell her to be good.
If you can pass a message back, tell her that I'm watching. Don't make me regret setting her free.
You won't. She seeks only peace.
Good.
Be well, Commander Shepard. You will not see me again.
Well, I have questions. Hey. I had investigate questions, damn it. And I went for the little side thing.
There we go. Run away, you bastards. Give up your colony plans.
That's disgusting. You're making money off people's fear.
Yes, I am.
Yes, I am.
Shipload. Whereas your stock just fell like it was in a high gravity environment.
Damn it.
Wow, I got... So it's not her? No. She's actually cuter. I don't know. I wanted to ask her.
You should try it my way. Look
at
how
a lot of lines.
I guess it's not like I attacked those colonies. I'm just watching trends.
Yeah.
Whatever you say. Pardon me.
Really?
Sell at 40.
They have a lot of lines, those two. Oh, Gianna Parisini.
Holy crap, Shepard. I thought you were dead.
From Novaria?
Shepard, the news said you were dead.
Yeah,
what
happened? You?
No, wait, probably classified. Forget I asked. You just have to lie.
I'm Gianna Parisini, Novaria Internal Affairs. You screwed over my corruption investigation of Administrator Analeas.
I didn't have a choice.
I was worried about bigger problems at the time. Saren was trying to destroy the galaxy.
No kidding. And using our labs for his experiments. Man, we caught some heat over that one. Anyway, I eventually got Analeas fired for screwing an Asari tax inspector, so it worked out. Have a seat. You can buy me a beer.
Sure.
What brings you to Ilium? You know, that you can talk about.
I'm hitting the collectors.
You ever heard of the collectors? They're attacking human colonies. I'm gonna stop them.
Damn, Shepard. For me, a tough job involves more paperwork. Hey, listen, I just remembered something. I've gotta go. Talk to you later. And don't forget to drink your beer.
Should I have told her that? Examine the beer. Shepard, had to leave. Target saw me. Couldn't break cover. Asari merchant smuggling schematics from Novaria. Can you talk her into showing you good stuff? Convince the tech merchant to show you smuggled merchandise. Eh. That's funny. How did she leave that message in her beer in such a short notice?
25. Sell at 25.
Checking in on these guys.
No, no, no. You're not hearing me. I want to buy it up.
Oh, they started
all
over.
Come on, come on. Give me something.
They've started over.
I'm looking for the best tech upgrades you have.
Of course. I can help you with a consult and figure out what options work for you.
Hmm. Okay, guys. Well, I'd love to keep going and break the episode into parts, but it's actually easier for me in the long run if I just break it like this. Stay tuned when I talk to the merchant here and look at stuff, browse things, and look at more of Ilium, and hopefully next episode finally meet up with Liara. Her suite or office overlooks the trading floor, and this must be it. So she's up there somewhere. Trying to catch sight of her. Well, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.